Hello, welcome to Optical Fiber Communication lecture series. Today we will discuss lecture 4 about multiplexing techniques in optical fiber communication. Request to like, share, comment, subscribe, and please do not forget to press bell icon to receive latest video from this channel. In fiber optic communication, multiplexing is considered to be the principal means for the expansion of existing fiber network engineering. Since optical data can be carried by employing different physical dimensions such as time, frequency, space, polarity, etc., different multiplexing techniques are possible to be used in increase the data carrying capacity of single optical fiber. This lecture will discuss multiplexing technique currently in use, that wavelength division multiplexing, optical time division multiplexing, and space division multiplexing. Wavelength division multiplexing, there are two types, coarse WDM and dense WDM. Coarse WDM and DWDM, or CWDM and DWDM, are based on the same concept of using multiple light wavelength on a single fiber, but differ in same spacing of the wavelength, number of channel, and the ability to amplify the multiplex signal in the optical space. In wavelength division multiplexing allows bidirectional communication simultaneously over a single optical fiber. The foundation of WDM simplifies the network to a single virtual optical fiber network instead of using a multiple form of signal with a different fiber and service. In this way, WDM increases the bandwidth and lowers the network cost by reducing the needed fiber. In WDM, different optical signals are combined or multiplexed together at one end of the optical fiber and separated or demultiplexed into different channels at the other end. Time division multiplexing is a simple way of transmitting more data by using a smaller and smaller increment of time and multiplexing lower data rate signal into higher speed component signal. OTDM is a multiplexing technique that basically multiplexes the number of low bitrate optical channel in this time domain. This is a single conductor, this is the E1, E2, E3, E4, is a time lower bitrate optical channel that are multiplexed with the help of optical time division multiplexing. Each signal is transmitted over a single communication channel by dividing the time frame into a slot. One slot for each message signal based on one time, each low speed channel is allocated to a specific position where it works in synchronized mode. That is to say, the multiplexer and demultiplexer are timely synchronized and simultaneously switched to the next channel. Usually, the optical pulse width is shortened in order to multiplex more channels within the fixed clock period. In addition, the shortened pulse width can reduce the crosstalk between the channels because of more room left in the bitrate. However, short pulse width results in heavy dispersion as traveling distance increases. Therefore, transformed pulse and dispersion slope compensation technique need to be used to reduce dispersion effect in OTDM. Space division multiplexing is a technology that utilizes the spatial dimension to simultaneously deliver different data streams by creating a parallel spatial channel. Space division multiplexing, or more commonly known as a parallel optics or parallel fiber, is a way of adding one or more lens simply by adding one or more optical fiber into the composite link. A LAN in this scenario is physically another fiber stand. It's an alternative to time division multiplexing LANs described above, where signals merge each in a time on the same fiber. There are a number of examples of this technique being used in the industry. This technique is commonly used in multi-input, multi-output system, MIMO. MIMO operate at least two antenna at the transmitter side and at least two antenna at the receiver side. And MIMO signal processing is already widely used in current coherent optical transmission system with polarization division multiplexing PDM over standard signal mode fiber. It is believed that by adopting strategy using multi-core and multi-mode fiber, long-haul transmission distance and high-speed data rate with high density STM are possible to achieve. Among all these multiplexing techniques, WDM or wavelength division multiplexing is the most widely used in optical communication. As different multiplexing techniques have their limitation in some aspect, it is usually suggested to use more than one technique in fiber optical network to get best transmission performance. These are the reference for this presentation. Request to once again like, share, comment, subscribe, and press bell icon to receive latest video information from this channel. Thank you.